A three-dimensional object creates a two-dimensional shadow. Similarly, a four-dimensional object would create a three-dimensional shadow. This is a three-dimensional shadow of a four-dimensional object rotating in different directions. Suppose we have a red light and a three-dimensional object that casts a shadow. The walls and the object appear red because they reflect the red light, whereas the shadow appears black because all light to it is blocked by the object. Let's add a green light that results in a second shadow. This new shadow appears red because the red light is still able to reach it, but the green light is blocked by the object. The original shadow now appears green because the green light is able to reach it, but the red light is blocked by the object. All the areas that are able to receive both red and green light appear yellow. Let's add a blue light that results in a third shadow. This shadow is yellow because the red and green light are still able to reach it, but the blue light is blocked by the object. Each shadow appears as the combination of the colors that are able to reach it. The regions where all three lights are able to reach appear as white. As the object rotates, notice how the two-dimensional shapes of each of the shadows are different from one another, and how they change with time. A rotating four-dimensional object could similarly cast a three-dimensional shadow shape that changes with time. Let us return to the example of the rotating three-dimensional cube. Whereas the three-dimensional cone was white, the three-dimensional cube has sections that are red, sections that are blue, and sections that are green. Notice how the shadow changes as we move the position of the light. Suppose we change the white light into a red light. Although the entire cube still casts the exact same shadow as before, only the red sections of the cube are able to reflect the red light. Therefore, only the red sections of the cube are now visible. All the other sections of the cube appear black because they absorb the red light. Let's now add a blue light, which makes the blue parts of the cube visible because they reflect blue light. The shadow behind the red light now appears blue, because the blue light is able to reach this part of the screen, but the red light is blocked by the object. Let's add a green light, which results in a third shadow. The shadow behind each light appears as the combination of the two other colors that are still able to reach the screen. Let's move the position of the lights so that all three lights are at the same location. All the lights together appear as a white light. Let's replace the cube with a sphere of balls. This rotating three-dimensional sphere of balls creates this two-dimensional shadow. If we had a rotating four-dimensional sphere of balls, it would create this three-dimensional shadow on our three-dimensional world. For the four-dimensional objects in this video, the colors are just added for illustration and do not signify an actual shadow color. Much more information about living in a higher dimensional world can be found in the video, Beauty of Geodesics. Special thanks to all the people supporting this channel on Patreon. Your support is very much appreciated.